안녕하세요. 박창주 교수입니다.
Greetings, I'm Professor Park Chang-ju. All dentists, especially those in Korea, are very interested in implants. In order to do implant surgery, surgical kit is imperative. I'm sure you have a lot of interest and questions about surgical kit. Most questions are around surgical kits. So I'm going to talk about the kit which is imperative for implant placement. This is OSSTEM's most prominent and most widely used 1-2 taper kit. 1-2 taper kit, as you can see, consists of taper drills. These small taper drills, what kind of secrets are there inside them? Let's look closely at them. Let's find out all the secrets of implant surgical kit. First, the contents. The first secret, taper drill. Second, stopper drill. It can be pronounced as stopper drills. Third, hidden figures will be addressed. Finally, I will summarize. I'm going to talk about the transformation of surgical kit. First, the drills, normally they were straight, and now it has taper. So that's why it's called a taper drill. That's the tendency these days. It's in relation to the fixture shape. And if you look at Dr. Park Jong-chul's master course preview, the explanation is there, so please take a look. Second, as we change to taper drill, drilling process has become simpler and faster. The drill shape has changed to tapered shape, and the cutting power has increased, and you can get predictable results. Most importantly, regardless of who does it, you get similar results. It doesn't matter if you're a novice or an expert, but if you use taper drill in taper kits, regardless of who does it, you can get similar results. Those of you who are new to OSSTEM, or if you have used Abana, this will look familiar to you. This is an implant surgical kit with early drilling concept. Do you still use Hanero kit? If you do, if you want to place TS3 4.0 in hard bone, you would probably drill like this. Lance drill shaped like a lance would be used to pierce the cortical bone, and a 2.0 twisted drill would be used. Because the drills were straight, in order to go to the next stage, 2.0, 3.0 pilot drilling was essential. After that, you would drill 3.0. Because it's a hard bone, drilling will be done up to 3.6, and cortical drill will be used, and then fixture will be placed in. How many drilling was necessary? 6 drilling was necessary. After that, OSSTEM's prominent taper kit. This was introduced. I'm sure a lot of you still use it. It's a kit for taper drill. TS3 4.0 fixture. If you're going to place it in hard bone, you'd use lance drill to pierce the cortical bone and use 2.2 twisted drill. An F3.5 taper drill would be used. After that, F4.0 taper drill, and because it's a hard bone, F4.0 taper cortical drill would be used. After that, fixture would be placed. How many steps were involved? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Although the cutting power was improved, it's not a huge difference from Hanaro kit. In 2016, it was released and it's a most prominent kit within OSSTEM and most people use it. It has gained a lot of attention. It doesn't look significantly different from taper kit. If you're placing TS3 4.0 in hard bone, you'd use guide drill and then F3.5 1-2 taper drill. And because it's a hard bone, in the sense that you over prep, you'd use F4.5 1-2 taper drill and then place the fixture. How many drill steps are required? 3 steps are required. It's quite significant. It's become much swifter and simpler, and displacement is less, so you get better results. However, 1-2 taper kit, when you first see it, you think there are way too many drills, and on the board, the instruments and drills are way too complicated. For novices and for doctors, this is a street drill kit by Noble Bio, and the drills, if they are straight, the board looks much simpler. If you're accustomed to this, you may find 1-2 taper kit way too complicated. Regardless of whether you're a novice or whether you're used to straight kit, I want to tell you this. It's actually quite simple. It's not difficult. Taper drill, in general, have F in front of them. This means the diameter of the fixture to be placed. After you use this drill, F4.5 means that 4.5mm fixture will be placed. Why is it different from existing drill? The straight drill or twisted drill in the image, if it says 3.0, it meant the diameter of the drill. That's why people find it more complicated. Taper drill, you can choose the drill following the diameter of the fixture to be placed. Depending on the length of the fixture, you can choose it. In other words, you just need to make a decision as to what kind of implant fixture you're going to use. For the drill, you just make a couple of choices depending on the diameter and length of the fixture. I'm going to go into deeper detail at master course, but please remember, the board may look complicated, but drilling, it's very simple. You need to make a few choices and think of the standard. The diameter and length of the implant of fixture. Depending on it, you just need to choose a couple of taper drills. The 1-2 taper kit. Most of the taper drills are stopper drills. On the top, there's a stopper. In other words, you don't go in to after a certain level. There's a stopper. In straight drill, there was no stopper, and there were marking drills. If there are no stoppers, the image looks much simpler. However, there is a problem. When you do drilling,
especially when you're a beginner,
when you use stopper drill, you don't need to worry about depth control. So when you drill, you just need to focus on the position and direction. However, in the case of marking drill, the depth is determined by the force you apply, and thus the significance of it increases. When you
drill, people get fixated on the depths and
of how much the laser marking goes in, and people don't pay attention to the direction and position of the implant. And these are major factors. If you do not have a lot of experience placing implants, you need to use stopper drills. It has much more usage. I'm going to show you my case. This patient in number 37, SS implant was placed. I'm sure you don't really see what's wrong. At the time of drilling, I used marking drill, and it was a drill without a stopper. What's the important anatomical structure below? Inferior alveolar nerve. Panoramic image? Maybe you can't see it. I'm sure you will not be able to see it even if you shift it around. Let's look at the panoramic cut. In number 37, you can see for sure that it's in contact with the inferior alveolar nerve. Implant's apex is in contact with the inferior alveolar nerve. It's because you used a marking drill. For novices, you need to use stopper drill. Another point. I've mentioned that I'm going to tell you a secret in taper kit. Stopper drill. It is the key in 1-2 taper kit, and it's a hidden secret. Third, when you do implant surgery, as shown, if you use TS3, it's a major implant fixture in OSSTEM. In other words, two-stage surgery, it has internal hex connection. As you already know, these implant needs to be at least 1 millimeter below the crest. Some place it deeper, but at the very least, we all agree that it needs to be placed deep. Stopper drill. What kind of structure does it have to ensure that it is placed deep? Below the stopper, there's 1 millimeter more than what is marked. Take a look at this drill. There's 7, 8.5, 10, 11.5. Below the thick band is 10, and above that is 11.5. This is an 11.5 drill. This drill, there is a 1 millimeter below the stopper, where my hand is. The crest, if it is in contact with stopper, you drill 1 millimeter deeper. Another point, when you open flap and look at the bone, it may be irregular or sloped. There are those kind of alveolar bones. Because there's 1 millimeter below the stopper, even if the alveolar crest is irregular or sloped, you may be able to place the implant in a normal way. You can get help from that. Unlike the marking drill, there is a 1 millimeter hidden below the stopper in the taper kit. Another point. If you look at the tip of the taper kit, approximately 1 millimeter is hidden. Let's look at the tip. It's not marked, but there's 1 millimeter more to the length.
As shown, if the drill becomes thicker, the bottom protruded portion, which is not marked, increases like this, so 0.6, 0.8, 0.9, 1.0.
If 4.5 or 5.0 and beyond, during surgery, in order to get a predictable result, there is a restriction of 1.0.
You don't need to remember all these figures, but just remember 1 millimeter.
This drill, even if it is 11.5 tapered drill, there is 1 millimeter at the bottom, and there's another 1 millimeter below the stopper. I'm talking about the 1 millimeter at the bottom. Why is it made this way? You need to understand mechanical engineering. It's for maximal cutting. By making it slightly sharp, not blunt, but by making it sharp, you can get maximal cutting, and it's very convenient for use. The couple of millimeter at the bottom, what did I say? This is called Y dimension. I'm sure you've heard of it before. It's shaped like a Y. The Y dimension equals the 1 millimeter that is hidden. The taper drill that we use frequently, there's 1 millimeter below the stopper. We need to understand that it's hidden. It's not marked, but we need to remember that. Let's summarize. I've talked about three hidden secrets of taper kit. First, the secret was taper drill itself. It's complicated but simple.
It doesn't matter if you're a beginner or an expert, you can get similar results.
What was the second secret? It was stopper drill. You can focus more on implant position and direction. Why? Because you don't need to pay too much attention on depth control. That's the second secret in taper drill. Third, there is something hidden below the stopper. There's also a millimeter hidden at the tip of the drill. It's not marked, but in critical situations, you need to be aware of these hidden factors.
What first comes to your mind when you look at surgical kit?
For me, in the beginning, I thought it was too much and there were too many components. But now, I can picture the entire kit with my eyes closed. Anyone can feel flabbergasted at first,
and it can feel foreign.
When you first open your surgical kit, you may have made a lot of mistakes, but you had that urge to succeed. I hope you remember and hold on to it.
Please remember that I'll always support you.
Thank you for watching.
항상 응원하도록 할게요. 함께 해주신 여러분, 고맙습니다.